People need to communicate electronically in today's world. They need to exchange data and information electronically with one another. A good communication system is a must for every organization. Organizations depend on interconnected networks of computers to service their information processing needs. We live in a networked or connected world. A network is a group of two or more computer systems linked together. Telecommunications is the sending of information in any form from one place to another using electronic or light emitting media. Data communications is a more specific term that describes the transmitting and receiving of data over communications links between one or more computer systems and a variety of inputs. Input terminals, all forms of telecommunications now rely heavily on computers and computerized devices. Overview of a network. Generally, a communication network is any arrangement where a sender transmits a message to a receiver over a channel consisting of some types of medium. The following figure illustrates a conceptual model of a network from figure 21 and consists of basic components. Terminals. Terminals include video display terminals and other end users, workstations. Any input or output devices that use the same network or transmit or receive data in a terminal. This includes microcomputers, telephones, fax machines, etc. Telecommunication processors. These are devices which support data transmissions and reception between terminals and computers. These devices, such as modem, multiplexers, and front processors, perform a variety of control and support functions in a network. For example, they convert data from digital to analog and back, code and decode data, and control the accuracy and efficiency of the flow of data between computers and terminals in a network. Telecommunications channels and media. The media over which data are transmitted and received are called telecommunications channels. Telecommunication channels use combinations of media such as copper wires, coaxial cables, fiber optics cables, microwave systems, and communications satellite system to interconnect the other components of a network. Computer. Networks interconnect computers of all sizes and type of that they can carry out their information processing assignment. For example, a mainframe computer may serve as a host computer for a large organization's network, assisted by many computers acting as network servers for smaller networks of end users' microcomputer workstations. Telecommunications software. Telecommunication software consists of programs that reside in host computer system, communications control computers, and end user computer. This controls the telecommunications active of the computer system and manages the functions of networks, no matter how large and complex the real world networks may appear to be. These five basic categories of components must be at work to support at a network. Communication processors. Communication processors resemble computers, CPU, in that they have smaller circuitry, have memories, and can be programmed, but their purpose is limited to enhance data communications. Between two points, communication processors include the following: modem, multiplexers, message switches, concentrators and controllers, and front-end processors. Modems. Modems are the most common type of communication processors. They convert the digital signal from a computer transmission terminal at one end of a communication link into analog signals which can be transmitted over ordinary telephone lines, a modem at the other end of the communications line converts the transmitted data back into digital form at the receiving terminal. The process is known as modulation and demodulation, and the word modem is a combined abbreviation of those two words. Modem come in several forms, including small stand-alone units, plug-in circuit boards, and microelectronic modem chips. Modems are necessary because ordinary telephone lines are primarily designed to handle continuous analog signals such as the human voice, which data transmissions from computers are in digital form. Devices are necessary to convert digital signal into appropriate analog transmission frequencies and vice versa. Multiplexers and concentrators and controllers. Like message switches, a multiplexer allows several terminals to use one line to communicate with a CPU. However, it allows the terminals to send their message simultaneously. A multiplexer, in other words, collects a message from various senders, put them in order, and transmit them along a broadband channel at very high speed to receiver. A concentrator is essentially a smart multiplexer. It can be programmed, has more processing capability, and is more flexible than a multiplexer controllers or cluster controllers, link groups of terminals or other devices to a communications channel. The controller pulls and status of such terminal and transformers data from a terminal to the host computer when necessary. Multiplexers, concentrators, and controllers are frequently used at terminal sites having heavy input and output requirements. Message switches. A message switcher is a processor that receives data message from terminals, determines their destination, and routes them one at a time to the CPU. It distributes message coming from CPU to the appropriate terminal. The advantage of message switches is that it reduces long distance transmission cost since only a single line is needed. Although only one terminal at a time can communicate with the CPU, message switches are efficient with low speed terminals that are intermittently used at remote sites. Front end processors. A front end processor is located at the site of the CPU or the host computer, and its purpose is to relieve the central computer of some of the communication tasks. Even the larger computer free for processing application programs. Here we can see that communication processing and data processing equipment are nearly alike. Indeed, front-end processors are computers. They have some identical circuitry and perform many of the operations that a data processing equipment performs. The only difference between the two kinds of equipment in their purpose, communications media. Channels, also called communications lines or links, are the means by which data is transmitted between the sending and receiving devices in a network. A channel makes uses of a variety of media. These include twisted pair wire, coaxial caps, and fiber optics cables, all of which physically link the device in a network. Also include a microwave system, communication satellite system, and cellular radio, all of which use microwave and other radio waves to transmit the received data. Twisted pair wire. This is oldest and still most common transmission line and consists of copper wires twisted into pairs. These lines are used in established communications networks throughout the world for both voice and data transmission. Coaxial cable. A coaxial cable consists of the sturdy copper or aluminium wire wrapped with a spacious to insulate and protect it. The insulation minimizes the interference and distortion of the signals, and cable carriers. Groups of coaxial cables may be bundled together in a big cable for ease of installation. These high quality lines can be placed underground, laid on the floor of lakes and oceans. They allow high speed data transmission. Fiber optic cables. Fiber optic uses cable consists of one or more hair thin filaments of glass fiber wrapped in a protective jacket. They can conduct light pulses generated by lasers at transmission rates and high as 2 billion bits per second. This is about 10 times greater than coaxial cables and 20 times better than twisted pair wires. Fiber optic cables provide substantial size and weight reduction, as well as increased speed and greater carrying capacity. A half inch diameter fiber optic cable can carry up to 50,000 channels compared to about 5,500 channels for a standard coaxial cable. Fiber optic cables are not affected by and do not generate electromagnetic radiation. Therefore, multiple